मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। आई एम सी जी लक्ष्मण प्रसाद, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ इंग्लिश, वर्किंग एट गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज आत्मकूर, वनपर्ति डिस्ट्रिक्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक। The topic comes under vocabulary British and American English. In this video, we are going to learn, see what are the differences in vocabulary pertaining to British English and American English. Let us go to some background, why they are different, why American English is different from British English. America and Britain are two nations divided by a common language. See the statement carefully. Two nations divided by a common language. Actually, in normal situations, it should be like that. Two nations, divided by two different languages or combined by a common language. But here divided, they have common language. America and Britain, they speak common language, that is English, but divided by a common language. That means even though it is a single language, they have different dialects. We cannot even call dialects as such. There are so many differences, and some differences are deliberate and historical, and all those things we are going to discuss. The British actually introduced the language to the Americas when they reached these lands by sea between the 16th and 17th century. Actually, when we when we see the history of America, America was the people of many countries. America belongs to the people of many countries, particularly Europeans. When America was discovered, people from all the countries of Europeans, they migrated to America. With the advent of Industrial Revolution, people lost their jobs and they did not have anything to do. That's why they started moving to America, and they started, different jobs. Particularly, they depended on agriculture. There was a vast land in America, and so pertaining to the language is concerned, even though they are from different countries, they were speaking different languages like Spanish, Portuguese, French, German, all those things. But when they have gone there, it was ruled by England. Okay, it was occupied. America was occupied by England, and England ruled America for many years. And there was, strife, like, Boston Tea Party. There were so civil wars. And because of all those things, America got independence. Okay. And they started, learning English, the other people. People other than England, those who migrated to America, they were started learning English. And English became their official language, and they slowly forgot their own language. Now people from America, they may be from Portuguese, but they forgot their language. They may be from German or French, they forgot their language, and English has become their mother tongue. But Spanish is still in vogue. Still in America, some people are speaking Spanish and English. Okay, the other languages are almost dead in America. Okay, except Spanish and English. And most of the people, they speak only English. And Spanish may be their other language, like second language. But first language is English. It has become first language. So when we think of 16th and 17th century, the history of English language, at that time, spelling had not yet been standardized. Even in England, they don't have any standard spelling as such, because we know that English, you know, it has borrowed many words from many languages, and everybody was writing their own spelling. Okay, there was no standard spelling, even pronunciation, and even there was no dictionary as such. Okay, in the UK, the dictionary was compiled by London-based scholars. Then slowly, they started writing the dictionary. And who wrote this dictionary? London-based scholars. So they have their own spellings. They developed their own spellings, and standardization of spellings started in England. But at the same time, in the meanwhile, in the United States as well, the lexicographer was a man named Noah Webster. Webster's dictionary we speak of. Okay, and he started writing his own dictionary, particularly for America. And he changed the how the words were spelled to make the American version different from the British. And his spellings were different from English spellings as a way of showing cultural independence from its mother country. So even though he was from England, he wanted to show some kind of difference from its mother country, and he started writing his own spellings. And these spellings have been standardized in America. Whose spellings? Webster's spellings became standardized in America, whereas London-based scholars' spellings became standardized in England. In that way, we have got two Englishes simultaneously. Simultaneously, they developed. In terms of speech, then if it comes to pronunciation, the differences between American and British English actually took place after the first settlers arrived in America. First settlers means, again, you know, they are from different countries, they have their own languages. These groups of people spoke using what was called rhotic speech. That means where the R sound, that is a ra sound of words, are pronounced. Whereas in England, Britishers, they avoided ra sound. Ra was mute. Ra is almost mute in British English, except if it is followed by a vowel. If there is a vowel, then R is pronounced, ra is pronounced. Otherwise, ra is muted. Where in England, that is by Britishers. Whereas in America, even today, ra is heard when they speak words. Okay, they say words. Britishers say words. Ra is not heard. Okay, even there are many words. Not only spellings and pronunciation, even grammar, there are differences. Many differences we can find in British English from American English. Let us see what actually we find, where we find differences. First one is spelling. There are so many words which differ in spelling. Not all, not 100%, but surely there are some words which differ in spelling in regard to American English and British English. Then pronunciation. Pronunciation also, like just now we discussed ra sound. Ra sound is not only ra sound, there are many other pronunciation differences as well. Then vocabulary, even words itself. Okay, Americans have different sets of vocabulary, and Britishers have different sets of vocabulary. That the same thing have two words. Americans use one word, Britishers use one word. And there are some words, okay, both of them use, but the meaning in America is different from the meaning in England. Okay, so we have differences in vocabulary and even grammar. Even grammar also, there are so many differences. So we are going to discuss all these things in this video. First, let us see differences in spelling. Okay, for example, color. Indians, as far as Indian English is concerned, we usually follow British English because English is taught to us by Britishers. But nowadays, we're shifting slowly from British English to American English. Now, in certain cases, we are using British English. In certain cases, we are using American English. But slowly, there is a shift, particularly after the computers have come into existence, after globalization, American influence has become very influence is very much inevitable in Indian English. So India is slowly shifting from British English to American English. But even though, even in our schools today, our textbooks and our everything, our grammar is totally based on British English. But slowly, we are shifting from British English to American English. It is evident. See now, color. COLOUR. Suppose when you are typing in the computer, in the Word document, if you type COLOUR, it says it is wrong. It has to be COLOR. Okay. But if you change the language to British English or Indian English, it doesn't show. Now we have option. But some 10 years back, or when computers have come into existence, there was no such option. There was only one language, American English. But now we have so many Englishes. Even we have Indian English as an option in our computer. And we can have our own English. Okay. Labor, LABOUR. But Americans, LABOR. UE is omitted. Even check, CHEQUE. Whereas it is CHECK. I feel that American spellings, American grammar, American change in pronunciation is very much logical and it appeals to the people. It has been simplified rather. Okay, British English looks like very archaic, and even spellings, and they are Roman based, Greek based spellings. But Americans, what they have done, they have simplified their language, by changing the spelling, by even adopting a new pronunciation of the word, even adopting new vocabulary, even changing certain things in grammar. Okay, we are going to discuss all those things in, not in detail, but in this video, we are going to discuss in detail about vocabulary, because we are, our topic is vocabulary, but other things we are going to just see, okay, one or two things, so that you understand how they differ. So difference is spelling, okay, we have seen. Then differences in pronunciation. I told you, ra is muted except when it is followed by vowel in British English. In British English, ra is muted except if it is followed by a vowel. For example, you see car. You don't say car, but Americans say car, bar, but Britishers say car, bar. Whereas caricature, there is vowel after ra. Okay, so caricature is pronounced same even in British English and American English. Okay, so such differences you can notice in British English and American English. Then ra is always pronounced and it is heard in American English. Whereas if you go to America, ra is heard. Okay. But Indians also where ra is heard. We follow British English, but still in certain cases we have changed British English to our own Indian English. So ra is heard. We say karu, car ochindi. Okay. Or something like that. Okay. We always pronounce ra like Americans. So that's the reason why we are slowly developing, we are evolving. Okay, Indian English is evolving now. Okay, maybe it gets standardized maybe after 5 to 10 years or maybe 15 years, but it has to be. Everybody, so many speakers are like R.K. Narayan, also like the one which we have studied in the lesson. He says that we have to have our own English. And then differences in vocabulary. I told you, vocabulary also, Americans have their own vocabulary and Britishers have their own vocabulary. So for example, sofa, coach. Sofa is British English and we know what is sofa is. Coach is a new word for us because coach means sofa, but coach is used in America. Now we are using that one as well. Then pavement is British English. Sidewalk is American English. See here you can see green words and red words. Throughout this PowerPoint presentation, I have used green words, for British English, red words for American English, so that it becomes very easy for you to understand. Then difference in toilet, restroom. Now we are, you know, everybody is using restroom. We don't want to use toilet. Okay, it's something like, you know, derogatory. We are using restroom. So slowly American English is getting into, actually both mean same. Toilet means, you know, same. We know what toilet is. We mean what restroom is. Okay, restroom sounds very good word. Okay, like, you know, cultured word. It's not like that. Both mean same. Okay, difference in grammar. You know, actually language is very dynamic. It always keeps changing. If you go to 10 years back, the English we spoke 10 years back is totally different from the English we are speaking now. And not only English, any language for that matter of fact. Suppose you Telugu, if you take, you watch some 20 years back old cinemas, black and white movies, you observe the language hero or heroine, the characters were speaking in those films, and it looks like a old, it is not at all relevant to the today's language. The words they are using, the way they are speaking is totally different. Totally different, because language is dynamic. That's what Noam Chomsky says. The main characteristics of the language is it keeps changing from time to time and from time, place to place. So difference in grammar. In American English, collective nouns are considered singular. Okay. Example, the band is playing. Whereas in contrast, collective nouns can be either singular or plural in British English. In British English, collective nouns, sometimes it is singular, sometimes it is plural. Although the plural form is most often used, example, the band are playing. The band are playing. Okay. In British English, we say band are playing. Whereas in American English, collective noun is considered as a singular. But British English, sometimes it is plural, sometimes it is singular. Then Americans continue to use gotten as a past participle of get. What is the past participle of the get for us? For Britishers, get, got. Whereas Americans still, they are using gotten, get, gotten. Even gotten was there in British English, but it was archaic. Now it is archaic. Nobody is using. In poetry and old poetry, we see that word. But now nobody is using gotten. But still, Americans, they are using gotten. Like that, needn't is very common in British English. Okay, needn't. Need is used, but needn't is used. Okay, like a helping verb. Very common in British English. Americans use don't need to. They say, I don't need to. I don't need. But Britishers, you know, Britishers, they don't, they say needn't. Okay, Britishers, it's very common. You needn't come. You needn't come. Like, you know, it looks like a helping verb. Need, dare. Okay, but Americans, they use them as, you know, main verbs. Okay, like that, there are so many differences. Not only these, even simple past tense, you know, present perfect. We say, I have finished my meals in British English. And Americans, they say, I finished my meal. I finished. They say, they use simple past tense. But Britishers use present perfect because just now you have completed. Like that, there are so many differences, but our concern is not grammar here. Our concern is only vocabulary. So I have only taken few examples, and maybe in some other time we can have a full video on grammar differences. Then here some interesting words are there, where same word is same, but different meanings in British English and American English. Word is same, but what it means in British English is different from what it means in American English. So here I have taken word and meaning in British English, meaning in American English. See the abbreviation British English, B capital letter, R small letter, E capital letter. The same way, A capital letter, M small letter, E capital letter, American English. So British English and American English. Boot. What do you mean by boot? For Indians, it means footwear. Okay. That's why I wonder why, you know, sometimes we have learnt American English. Why sometimes we stuck to British English? The trunk of a car, British English, it means trunk of a car, boot. We say boot, booting space. We use even in Indians also, India also we use. But many people, boot means footwear. But footwear meaning is American English. Okay. Then coach. Okay, we use this one. Coach means bus. Deluxe coach. Okay. Like that. Bus. Coach means bus. Whereas in America, it means a person who coaches a team. This also we use. Both are used in India. But whereas in Britain, coach means bus. In America, coach means a person who coaches a team. Cricket coach, football coach, kabaddi coach, like that. First floor. What is the first floor? In India, we follow British English as far as this word is concerned. We have ground floor. We have ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, like that. Whereas in America, there is no ground floor. Ground floor is called first floor, second floor, third floor, fourth floor. Okay, like that. So Americans seem to be more logical here. So first floor, a floor above the ground floor. And now suppose if you say, if you are in England and if you say, I am in the first floor, it is actually second one. Okay. Whereas if you are in America, if you say first floor, it is ground floor, the first one. Okay. Even in India, we are using British English as far as this word is concerned. Then trainer. Trainer means in British English, tennis shoes or running shoes. Shoes are called trainers. Okay. Whereas in American English, a person who trains, okay, he is a trainer, like swimming trainer or a football trainer or, you know, whatever it is. Trainer means, you know, both are, you know, in vogue in India. Then bog. Bog is a new word for Indians. We don't use actually. Okay. But in England, they use bog. Bog means bathroom. Whereas in America, bog means wet, muddy, soft ground. Wet, muddy, soft ground. Marshy land. Okay. It's called bog. Then trolley. Trolley means a cart with wheels. Suppose you go to any, this one mall. Okay. There you find trolleys. Okay. There whatever you want, you can keep them and, you know, then you can collect all those things in the cart. Trolley. Okay. But actually, in America, it means electric vehicle on tracks. It is like electric train. Electric train is called trolley. Okay, usually in city trains, actually. In city, just one or two coaches will be there. That one is called trolley. Okay. Then chips. Chips means in English, it is British, it's French fries, strips. It's not a small one. It's like, you know, French fries. We call in English French fries. Actually, these French fries are called chips. Whereas in America, chips means, we know, even India, chips means, we know, small, you know, that potato is sliced into very thin, that one is called chips. That is American English. Whereas in Britain, in England, chips means French fries. Then lift. Lift means in British English, elevator. Whereas American English, they use elevator. Elevator word is actually American English. So as to make you understand, I could not find any other word. So elevator I have used. Elevator is actually American English. Okay. Then what does lift mean in American English is, oh, just to pick. Suppose you pick, I'm lifting it. Okay. I'm lifting the bottle. I'm lifting something. Okay. I'm lifting a rock. Lift means to pick up or to raise. Okay. Then jumper. Jumper means, in British English, it is a sweater. Sweater. Actually, sweater again is American English word. Okay. But whereas the meaning of jumper in American English is a person about to jump. One who is going to jump, or one maybe for he has decided to suicide. Such person is called jumper. Okay. Whereas jumper in British English means just a sweater that we use in our winter. And here, same meaning, different things. In earlier slide, same word, different meanings. but here same meaning or same thing but different words in British English and American English. See, British English again, green words are British English, American words are in red color. Okay, see, autumn, fall. Autumn, we have four seasons, you know. Autumn is one of them. Summer, winter, autumn, like that. Fall is American English for autumn. Cash point, ATM. Okay, Britishers call cash point, but Americans call ATM. See, slowly American English is getting into India. Now, nobody knows cash point. Okay, nobody uses cash point. Everybody in India uses ATM only. Okay, crossroads, intersection. See, crossroads. Crossroads, we say crossroads in British English, whereas in American English, it is intersection. Dustbin, trash can. Dustbin, trash can. Flyover, overpass. Flyover. In India, we use a flyover. But, even Britishers also use the same. Americans use overpass. Full stop, period. Okay. Holidays, vacation. Okay, both are in vogue in India, as far as India is concerned. But the Britishers use holidays, Americans use vacation. Then lorry, okay, lorry, British English, whereas in American English, it is truck. Mobile phone, cell phone. India, both are used. Then biscuit, cookie, okay. Now slowly we are shifting, you know, those educated people, they use cookies because it has become, American English has become fashionable English. Whereas British English has become archaic for us. Slowly we are shifting from British English to American English. If somebody says, somebody goes to a mall and ask biscuits, they will look at you as if you are from some village. Okay, you have to ask cookies. Okay, biscuit, cookies. Chemist, drugstore. Okay, chemist is British English, drugstore is American English. Curtains, drapes. Curtains in British English, the same thing are called drapes in American English. Flat, apartment. Football, soccer. Handbag, purse. Lift, elevator. Luggage, baggage. Petrol, gasoline. Even in India we use petrol, but in America they use gas or gasoline. Okay, gas, many people use gas. Gas station, they say. Gasoline station, gas station, like that. Then some more. Actually, you know, I have collected many words for you to know so that we can actually discuss. Otherwise, there is no way we can learn the differences. And all the words which we use in day-to-day life, I have collected. Photo, picture. Photo is in British English, picture is in American English. Queue, line. Okay, queue means we know. In India, we use both queue and line. Line in American English. Tap, faucet. Okay, tap, we use tap. But America, they use faucet. Term, semester. Term, first term, second term, third term, we say. At American, it is semester. Now, we have come to semester system. That is slowly, American English is getting into India. Toilet, restroom. Already discussed. Trousers, pants. Okay. Trousers, pants. Now we are using pants. Okay, in earlier old English, it used to be trousers. Even Indians used to use trousers. But now we are using pants. Crisps, chips. See, crisps, a small one. Thin ones were called crisps in British English. The same thing were called chips. Okay. Then cinema, movies. British English, it is cinema. Whereas in American English, it is movie. Aeroplane, airplane. See the spelling? Aeroplane, A-E-R-O-P-L-A-N-E, aeroplane in British English, whereas in American English, it is airplane, A-I-R-P-L-A-N-E. Then post, mail. Post is British and mail is American. Staff, faculty. Okay. Even in universities nowadays, they are using faculty. They say, I'm English faculty mass faculty, science faculty, arts faculty. Okay. Then taxi, cab. Now we are talking about cabs. Earlier, it used to be taxi. Go see old movies. They used to use taxi. But now, new movies, cab. They are using cab. Timetable, schedule. Torchlight, flashlight. Wardrobe, closet. trainers sneakers. Trainers mean shoes. The same shoes are called sneakers in American English. Plaster, band-aid. Bonnet, hood. Bonnet means, you know, car. The same thing is called hood in American English. Then, cotton bud, cotton swab. Cotton bud, cotton swab. Earth, electrical. Electrical sense, you know, we say earthing. The third wire. Positive, negative, earthing. Earthing. We say earthing in British English, whereas American English is a grounding, ground. Financial year, fiscal year. Okay, financial year means, you know, even now in India, we are talking about fiscal year. Slowly it is changing from financial year to fiscal year. Goods train, freight train. Goods train, freight train. Kennel. Kennel means dog house. Dog house. Americans use dog house. Mass, math. Mass is British English. Math is American English. Monkey tricks. Okay. Monkey shines. See the difference? Monkey tricks and monkey shines. Even while I was collecting these words, I learned many words. Even I did not know. Okay. For example, monkey shines. It's a new for me also. So it is a continuous learning. Okay. Mom, mummy. Even in India, we say mummy. But Americans, mom, mommy. Okay. Now, slowly, our children started calling mom. Okay. Mom has gone. Okay. I don't know how these children are picking up American English. Newsreader, newscaster. Okay. Newsreader is still vogue in India. Maybe after some time, it can be newscaster. Then, driving license, driver's license. Engaged. Okay, if you are not able to get connection, British English, it is called engaged. But in American English, it is busy. Okay, now we are using, the phone is busy. Garden, lawn. Indicator on a car, like a right indicator, left indicator. In American English, they say turn signal. Maize, corn. Milometer, odometer. Motorway, highway. Motorway. It used to be, but now even in India we are using highways. Nappy, diaper. Diaper. In India also, many people are using diapers now. I mean word. Number plate, license plate. Number plate in British English, whereas in American English it is license plate. Then open cast mining, open pit mining. Mining. Physiotherapy, physical therapy. Passcode, zip code. Ring road, beltway. See, beltway, we know ring road. But in America, the same thing is called beltway. Skipping rope, jump rope. Starter, appetizer. If you go to hotel, you order first starters. Okay, but the same thing is called appetizer. Trading estate, industrial park. Trading estate, industrial park. Zebra crossing, crosswalk. Then windscreen, car. Windscreen, windshield. Then British English. Pedestrian crossing, crosswalk. Postal vote, absentee ballot. We use postal ballot it's also, but absentee ballot is new for us. Push chair, stroller. Patients are they use a push chair, whereas the same thing is called stroller. Shopping trolley, shopping cart. Solicitor general, we say lawyer. The same one is called lawyer. Trade union, labor union. Underground, subway. Phone box, phone booth. Rubber, eraser. Rubbing, we use now rubbing, rubber. The same thing is called eraser in American English. Then British and American English, some exercises. Now we have already learned so many words. Now we are going to do some exercises. Replace American English word in italics with the British English word. So some are in italics. Actually, I'm using red color. Okay, the same similar word in British English you have to choose. Where Did you actually did some spelling error? Where did you buy the drapes? They are beautiful. So drapes are called curtains in British English. The elevator. Now this is American English. We have to use British English. The elevator is out of order. Please use the stairs. So elevator is called lift in British English. I would like to buy a new purse. So purse is called handbag in British English. Haven't you been Rishi's new apartment yet? It is huge and beautiful. Apartment is called flat in British English. I have fever. Please bring me some medicines from the drugstore. So drugstore is called chemist in British English. On my way to the city, I shall stop by to fill my car with gas. Gas is called petrol in British English. Please clear the baggage from the aisle. Baggage is called luggage. I am planning to go on a tour after my second semester. Term is called term in British English. The buses are off the roads. Let's get back home by a cab. Cab is called taxi in British English. Look at my closet. It's full of new dresses. Closet is called wardrobe in British English. Let's take another example, another exercise. Replace a British English word in italics with an American English word. Okay. It's a paragraph actually. So wherever we have to find a British English and we have to change it to American word. Okay. Yesterday, I drove to the city in my car. I stopped in front of a cash point. So cash point means ATM, we know. ATM is American word. To ask for directions, a young boy told me to take a left turn at the crossroads and ask again at the petrol station. So petrol station is called gas station. There, a man told me to take the first exit after the flyover. So flyover is called overpass. On the way, I saw trucks. Trucks means lorries. Okay. Carrying goods. Goods means freight. After I had crossed a huge flat. So this is British English. American English is apartment. Okay. Mixed. I packed my car and walked to the stadium to watch a football. So football, soccer. The equivalent word for football in American English is soccer. Like that. Some more examples. Some more exercises. Fill in the blank with the appropriate words. That means they have given either American English word or a British English word. We have to choose the other one. Okay, let us see. In London, you buy biscuits. If you go to London, what do you buy? You biscuits. Or the confectioners. Confectioners, sweet makers. Okay. In the US, you buy cookies. The same thing is called cookies in America. In the US, that means America, you take a cab. In the UK, you take a dash, taxi. In the UK, you wear trousers. In the US, you wear pants. In the US, you plan to go on a vacation. In the UK, you go on holiday. You go on a holiday. So vacation, equivalent word is holiday. You wait in a queue to board a bus in the UK. In the US, you wait in a line. In the US, a period is put at the end of every sentence. In the UK, what is equivalent for period? A full stop is put. In the UK, you click your photo. In the US, you take your picture. So photo means picture. In the US, you talk on a cell phone. In the UK, you talk on a mobile phone. Cell phone, mobile phone. In the UK, school's timetable is displayed on the notice boards. In the US, schedule is displayed. Even for notice boards, you know, it's called bulletin boards in America. When there is a blackout, means a power cut. Okay, blackout in the UK, you light a torch. In the US, you use a flashlight. Okay, like that. I think one more exercise is there. Let us see this one. Have you seen the movie that released yesterday? See here, it is American English. Actually, identify the italicized word as American English or British English. word and give the alternative word. Actually, they have given one word, and we have to say whether it is American English word or British English word, and you have to give an alternative word. Okay. So movie is an American English, and what is an alternative in British English? Cinema. I have applied for my driving license. Driving license is British English. The equivalent word is driver's license. Please submit your resume. Resume is American English by tomorrow. Whereas in England, they use curriculum vitae or CV. Curriculum vitae or CV. I left my room key at the reception, British English. The equivalent word to reception is front desk. Some words are missed actually in the collection. Here they have come. I displayed the poster on the notice board. So notice board is called bulletin board in American English. The janitor, American English, opened the rooms when we arrived. Janitor, American English. The equivalent word in British English is caretaker. His car bonnet, British English. Bonnet means British English, was badly damaged in the accident. So equivalent word for bonnet is hood in American English. The parking, American English, a parking lot, actually, not parking, parking lot, it should be. Parking lot was full. So parking lot in British English is called car park or car parking or simply parking. He asked me to call him tomorrow. He asked me to call him tomorrow. The call means a phone, by phone. The same thing is to ring. Okay. I'm very fond of my motorcycle. Motorcycle is American English. The equivalent word for motorcycle is motorbike in British English. I think we have discussed many concepts, many words, and even grammar points, pronunciation, so many things, how American English is different from British English, or how British English is different from American English. And now, slowly India is moving from British English to American English because of technology and because of globalization. Because of many people are moving to America. So slowly we are adopting American English. So it is important for us to learn the differences between these two languages, these two dialects. And at the same time, we have to have our own English, that is Indian English. That's very important. R.K. Narayan says, Bharat brand of English. Bharat brand of English. And it is true. We should have our own English. Thank you very much. If you like my video, please like my video. In the same way, like my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.